Mars. The red planet that has graced humanity's horizon for decades. For many of us, it is a familiar destination from science fiction films and books, a grand dream that has been waiting for generations to be reached. So, as the calendars continuously advance, and the promised dates are left one by one behind, why have we still not set foot on Mars? The answer is far more complex than we might think. Because going to Mars is not just about firing a rocket and setting off. The problem begins with the vast emptiness of 55 million kilometers between us, even at our closest point. Even with today's most advanced chemical rocket technology, this journey takes 6 to 8 months, according to the most optimistic estimates. And this long duration means complete devastation for the human body. Every day we spend in the zero-gravity environment of space takes something away from our bodies. Astronauts lose a significant amount of muscle and bone tissue during long missions. Their bones thin, their muscles weaken, their circulatory and immune systems suffer serious damage. And on top of all this, there is an invisible enemy, cosmic radiation. No matter how well we insulate our spacecraft, the crew is exposed to health-threatening levels of radiation during a journey lasting months. The solution is actually simple. We don't just need to go to Mars, we need to go as fast as possible. This is where chemical rockets fall short. Although they provide the necessary thrust, they have to carry a terrifying amount of fuel to produce this power. This makes the rocket heavier, slows it down, and increases the cost. A vicious cycle. So, what is the alternative? The answer lies in a technology that has been in the dreams of scientists since the 1950s, nuclear engines. Initially, engines based on fission, the principle of splitting the atom used in nuclear power plants, were considered. But in recent years, the technology that has truly shone is one that imitates the universe's most fundamental energy source, fusion. Fusion is the very reaction that occurs in the heart of the Sun and other stars. This process, which releases unimaginable amounts of energy by combining light atomic nuclei to form a heavier nucleus, is thought by institutions like NASA to be the key to deep space travel. Theoretical calculations and preliminary studies show that fusion engines could propel a spacecraft to mind-boggling speeds of 500,000 kilometers per hour. This speed means a revolution that could reduce a conventional Mars journey from months to weeks. So, how do you create a miniature sun inside a rocket? The most popular method today is based on a design called a tokamak. The process works like this. Elements like deuterium or helium-3, which is planned to be brought from the moon in the future, are used as fuel. This fuel is first turned into a gas and confined in a chamber surrounded by incredibly powerful magnets. The magnets create a magnetic shield that prevents the gas from touching the walls. Then, this gas is both heated and spun at a dizzying speed within the magnetic field. When the temperature reaches millions of degrees, the gas transforms into plasma. The magnetic fields compress this super-hot plasma even further, and at some point, the atomic nuclei within the plasma begin to fuse with each other. That is the moment the fusion reaction occurs, and a massive energy burst is released. This energy and the resulting particle bombardment are precisely directed to the engine's exhaust by magnetic fields. This process creates an extraordinarily high and continuous thrust. Moreover, this reaction can indirectly power all the electrical needs of the spacecraft. That is the moment the fusion reaction occurs, and a massive energy burst is released. This energy and the resulting particle bombardment are precisely directed to the engine's exhaust by magnetic fields. This process creates an extraordinarily high and continuous thrust. Moreover, this reaction can indirectly power all the electrical needs of the spacecraft. Sounds perfect, doesn't it? However, fusion rockets also have two major and dangerous problems. The first is weight. Although they may look compact from the outside, the massive magnets, power sources, cooling systems, and radiation shields required to sustain a fusion reaction in a stable and safe manner increase the engine's weight by tens of tons. Escaping Earth's gravity with this extra weight requires even more chemical fuel and restarts that infamous nightmare of the rocket equation. The second and more frightening problem is safety. A fusion engine, if it goes out of control, is theoretically no different from a thermonuclear bomb. Imagine for a moment that a launch accident like the Challenger disaster happened with a nuclear-powered rocket instead of a conventional one. An accident would cause a nuclear catastrophe affecting not just the launch site but a vast geographical area. The risk of using these engines within Earth's atmosphere is, in a word, unacceptable. So how can we benefit from the speed of fusion while avoiding these terrifying risks? This is where a UK-based company called Pulsar Fusion steps onto the stage with an ingenious solution. Their commercial fusion engine project, named Sunbird, aims to eliminate these two fundamental problems. The core of the idea is this: never launch nuclear engines from Earth. Pulsar Fusion's plan is as follows. The Sunbird engines will be manufactured in factories on Earth and transported to orbit unfueled and inactive by conventional safe rockets. In orbit, a space station, a kind of motor garage, will be waiting for these engines. When you want to go to Mars or Jupiter, what you need to do is this. You take off safely with a conventional rocket and your crew and dock at this orbital station. Here, one or more modular Sunbird engines are attached to your spaceship. Once this connection is complete, the engines are fired and they begin to push you towards your destination at an incredible speed. When you complete your mission and return, you stop by the station again, leave the nuclear engines there, and land on Earth completely clean and safe. This plan solves both problems in a single move. You get rid of the trouble of lifting heavy nuclear engines out of Earth's gravity, and most importantly, you completely eliminate the risk of a nuclear accident on Earth's surface. Pulsar Fusion claims that with this technology, it will be possible to travel to Mars in a record time of 4 months, and even reach Neptune and Pluto in the outer ring of the solar system in just 4 years. The project's tests are scheduled to begin this year, with the first orbital trial in 2027 and commercial use targeted for the 2030s. Of course, delays are inevitable in such projects, but the idea is powerful enough to rewrite the rules of space travel. Perhaps the path to the Red Planet is not hidden at the top of a giant rocket, but in a modular nuclear engine waiting for us in orbit. One of humanity's greatest dreams may be on the verge of coming true with a design that is more clever than we ever expected. The future truly looks exciting.